Okay, Michael, so that wraps up all this Bayesian learning stuff. What have we learned today?
We did Bayes rule.
We learned Bayes rule. We even learned how to derive Bayes rule.
And it was super useful because it lets you swap kind of causes and effects.
So I like the way you put that, Michael, that we're swapping causes and effects. Sort of mathematically, when we think about Bayes rule, what that really lets us do is instead of having to compute the probability of the hypothesis given the data, we instead get to compute the probability of the data given the hypothesis, which is typically a much easier thing to do. And what makes it, of course, Bayes rule in general is that you weight that by the prior probability over the hypothesis, which in fact is one of the important things that we learned, which is that priors matter. So anything else we learned?
Yep, we did the MAP hypothesis, maximum a posteriori.
Right. We learned about HMAP, and we also learned about HML.
ML, right, the maximum likelihood hypothesis.
Right, and what's the maximum likelihood hypothesis? How does it relate to the maximum a posteriori hypothesis?
It's the MAP that you get when the prior is uniform.
Right.
All right, and we connected up maximum a posteriori and least squares.
Yeah, that was pretty. I really like that. So we basically derived a bunch of things we've been doing before and sort of showed that there's actually a good argument for them, at least if you're a Bayesian. There are good arguments for doing sum of squared errors. There are good arguments for Occam's razor. We've actually able to give real justification for doing them other than, well, sure, it makes sense. Why not?
Right. So that includes the minimum description length story.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, you told me that was all a lie, and you said that really what you want to do is this other kind of way of picking that actually factors in the probability of all the different hypotheses and having them essentially vote.
Right. What we really care about is classification or learning in the end, and so we also learned about Bayes classifiers. So in fact, what we described before, which is voting of hypotheses, turns out to be the Bayes optimal classifier. I didn't say that, but it is very important to note. And in fact, what you should be noting there is not only is it the Bayes optimal classifier, it's the Bayes optimal classifier. And what that means is that on average, you cannot do any better than basically doing a weighted vote of all the hypotheses according to the probability of the hypothesis given the data. You cannot do any better than this on average. So again, what Bayesian learning gives us and what Bayesian classification gives us is a way of talking about optimality and gold standards. What do you think, Michael?
That's really neat.
I like it. I mean, I have to tell you, I really think that this stuff is kind of cool. It's always nice to be able to take things that actually work and explain them according to some framework or some underlying theory.
I wonder, though, it seems like all these Bayesian equations lead us to the question of how we actually infer probabilities from various different quantities and observations. So is there a way to do that?
So I think the answer is yes, and maybe you should go figure it out and then tell me about it next time.
Okay. All right. Yeah. As you wish.
As you wish.
Stay tuned.
Anyway, this has been a lot of fun, Michael. I will talk to you later.
Thanks.
Bye.